So she is known as the first martyr at sea. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Haram radiallahu anha was again one of the greatest companions of our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. She was the daughter of Milhan, Haram bint Milhan, which makes her the sister of Sulaim, who, you know, is the mother of Anas radiallahu an, the wife of Abu Talha radiallahu an, and they are sisters, which makes them both aunts of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And she was also married to another really famous companion, Ubadah ibn Samit radiallahu an, and she had a very close relationship with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, especially after he arrives in Medina. He migrates to Medina and he settles there. Haram radiallahu anha used to quite often invite him over, and our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam frequently used to visit the house of his aunt Haram. And on one such occasion, our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is there and he's resting, and it's narrated that Haram, you know, prepares a light meal for him, and she's so close to him that she's even, you know, checking his hair for any lice. Okay, and our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he rests there and he takes a nap in her home. And on one occasion, he wakes up smiling. And Haram radiallahu anha, she spots this and she asks our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, "What makes you smile, O Messenger of Allah?" And our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, he narrates that he has just seen a dream, and within that dream, he's seen some of his companions. They're out there on the sea, kal muluk. They are riding on the sea like kings. And Haram radiallahu anha, she's extremely intelligent, and she takes this opportunity to ask the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, to request him to make dua and to supplicate and to ask that Allah makes her from amongst these people. And our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam confirms that she will in fact be one of them. And it's narrated that he goes back to sleep, he wakes up again smiling, and then she asks him the same thing, and he narrates the same dream, that I saw my companions, you know, riding on the sea like kings, and she makes the same request, and our Prophet ﷺ confirms that she will be one of them. Now, you know, if you look at many of the battles and the expeditions that took place within the lifetime of the Prophet ﷺ, none of them took place, you know, on the sea, or none of them took place even near the sea. Majority of them were on land. So when did this happen and did this take place? Yes, it did. We have to fast forward many, many years later, after the Khilafah of Abu Bakr and Umar, into the time of Uthman radiallahu an. Many of the scholars say under the rule of Muawiyah, under his authority radiallahu an, the Muslims set off for one of their first expeditions on sea, one of their first naval battles. And they're going now, you know, by this point, of course, Islam has spread all across Arabia, you know, towards Abyssinia, towards, you know, Syria, Damascus, towards Palestine, you know, all across the Roman Empire, even into the Persian Empire. And now we're talking small, small islands, which today we know as Cyprus. And this is where they're going. And who joins that army? None other than Haram radiallahu anha, with her husband Ubadah radiallahu an. And they are there, and just like our Prophet ﷺ described, they are going for the sake of Allah, in the cause of Allah, for this expedition. And within this battle, subhanallah, Haram radiallahu anha, it's narrated that she actually falls off her mule, she falls off her ride, her mount, and she ends up breaking her neck. And this is actually where she is martyred, which then makes Haram radiallahu anha the first martyr at sea in Islam, in our history, for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And she has this legendary status up until today. And subhanAllah, even if you check on this island, Cyprus, till this very day, there is a masjid, and that masjid is called Masjid Haram. Wow, how amazing is that? And really, this is what makes her also from the Wonder Woman. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be pleased with her.